opening statements. Todd.
All right, guys. I'm stoked to be here tonight. And, you know, first thing I want to say really is thank you for being where you are and helping me to get in this spot in the game. I know that I played a game where I had to lie and I had to backstab and I had to hurt people that I cared about. And the main thing I can ask tonight is that you are able to see the difference between my strategic game and the relations that I actually built with you. Because the relations on a personal level, honest, real. The game level, the strategic level, is what I came here to do. I knew coming into game I was not the most physical, but I knew that I could be the most strategic. And if I did that, I could get here. This is my dream come true. I've lived my dream, and you know, you guys have all been a part of it. And I'm happy to answer whatever questions, hear whatever you have to say about me. I'm ready for it. But I really do want to say thank you for helping me in the game. It means the world to me. So, thanks.
Todd, day one, I went to you. I said, Todd, you know what? You're the schemer here. I know it. I'm on to you. You have the knowledge and you have the smarts. We had a plan to send James home. The best move for all of us at that time was to get rid of James, okay? In my opinion, you organizing to blindside me. Yeah, you blindsided me. Okay, I'm out of the game. But I wasn't the biggest threat.
You started to strategically place ideas in people's heads, which is what I wanted my job to be. And when you had approached me about blindsiding James, I was like, oh no, he's catching up. So who then becomes the biggest threat to me? You. What do I have to do? Turn it around on you, who is an extremely great strategic player in your daily life. I had to get rid of my biggest strategic threat, who's you.
Guys, congratulations. Well done.
That was a good answer.
Isn't that annoying?
James, I'm confused. What are you laughing at?
Because he shut him up. I know.
Honestly,
I'm in awe. He shut his mouth.
Todd, you talked about having played a really strategic game. You say that you played it hard. You know, I want to know that you didn't just slide in here because somebody decided you were going to be easy to beat.
First, I didn't slide anywhere. I started working day one. John Rivera called me out, said I'm a sneaky, sly little bastard that was going to get through this game and he had to watch out for it. He was right. Second, I gathered my numbers. I got myself Amanda, got myself Courtney, right? I was like, good, I've got some numbers. Pulled in Denise. We get to the merge, we pick you guys off, then it's a head-to-head battle, but I still got my numbers. I fought. It's a glorious battle. Art of War, yin and yang, I came out as a fighter.
Todd, you know, I love you, but I don't even know if I know you. You lied up, down, left, and right, and all the way back around in a circle. Why do you think that your gameplay deserves a vote from Frosty?
I think you're a great kid. My personal relations were different than my game relations. And yes, I did know that I wanted to take you in, be close with you, make myself a buddy, and put you on a jury. And what I built with you as a friend was real. But yeah, I did do a big, huge lie to my buddy Frosty. I'm sorry.
All right. Hey, you gotta do it.
Todd, we're gonna skip that question to Courtney and go, why doesn't Courtney deserve $1 million? What has she done?
Courtney's voted the same as me pretty much the whole time. I mean, I may have made the lies up and coordinated them. She's voted as me, so she's just as much of a liar as I am.
Except I didn't lie to y'all. I just went along.
She just went along. That's it. The reason why you should not vote for Courtney
is
because she didn't want to be here in the first place.
So do you think she deserves it at all, or do you think...
I think I deserve it more than her.
Okay, great. He lied too much for me.
I don't know if I'd make an alliance.
Todd, this is your chance.
Right.
You just heard what Amanda said about you. First of all, is what she said legit, or was there strategics behind you lying?
I mean, yeah, I told more lies, and yeah, I made more, you know, like, let's go far togethers than Amanda, but I did the dirty work for the nice girl.
And Courtney, do you think she rode your coattail and she's the only reason she's here is because of you?
I would say that they definitely played their game strategically, but I played mine more strategically.
Okay. That's fair enough.